Thanksgiving 2018 is in the books, and now the focus is on Christmas. But what if controversial topics came up during Thanksgiving dinner, whether it was different views on politics or something else? Now, some of your relationships with some family may be a little strained after Thanksgiving dinner. So how do you mend those relationships before Christmas? Joining me now this morning is Karen Hanson, a mental health therapist with the Jewish Family and Community Services. This is something that a lot of people struggle with in their families. Absolutely. They actually don't look forward to the holidays because they know there's going to be some tension.
Absolutely. It's so common. All we have to do is watch a sitcom or a movie and find out how many families get into conflict. And there was actually a study done, and out of 4,000 people, two-thirds thought that there was going to be another squabble in their holiday. So it's very common.
So what do you do if there is an issue, you know, whether it's over politics, religion, whatever family drama happens over Thanksgiving, how do you fix that? Because you know, okay, in a month, I'm going to see these people again.
Right. So what you can do is really talk to them. And so you call them, not text them, not use social media, but you call them and say, hey, you know, I really value this relationship. Can we sit down and can we talk about it? And then the next thing is you have to listen. You have to really listen to their perspective and think about, this is a sentence that I use in my life all the time, is it more important to be right or to be happy? And if you really want this relationship to work, then it's time to really listen and then share your point of view from that. I just want this relationship to work.
If the person still seems combative or short, what else could you do besides a conversation? I mean, send flowers, say I'm sorry, you know, what else could possibly be done?
Well, I think the conversation is the most important because then you have a chance to air it out. But you could send a card and say, you know, I'm sorry, or I'm thinking about you, or I would really like to have a better outcome in our holidays. And that's really important. So that study I referenced, two-thirds of them predicted that there was going to be a problem. So how about we predict that there's not going to be a problem? We focus on an outcome, and then we have a choice. We cannot control other people.
Would it be a good idea to even say, you know what, clearly we do not see eye to eye on this issue. I respect you, but let's just not talk about this ever again.
Absolutely.
I mean, is that healthy?
It is. And also, you can just agree to disagree. Yeah. We're not going to always agree with our family members or friends. But just being able to say, let's table this. Let's come back to this at another time. Let's have positive family memories. Let's make this a good, good holiday.
You know, I know there's people that are out there and they haven't spoken with a loved one in years. Would this be a good time to maybe reach out? Because our lives are only so long.
You never know, exactly. And that falls back to the, is it more important to be happy or right? We get so locked into, and sometimes we don't even remember what we were fighting about. So it is time to reach out and try to mend some of that. But you can only control your own behavior.
Yeah, if they don't want to fix things, then.
But we do have other options, too. You can find a neutral person, a professional person that can come in, like a therapist.
Right.
You know, DuBois Counseling Center. I work with a lot of couples or families, parent-child, adult-parent-child, and we work on issues that happened in childhood and really try to mend it.
Well, thank you so much, Karen, for that advice. Thank you.